days of the journey in the desert had begun to blend together, and the mirages had begun to feel like real water, but water that never quenched, washed, or cooled. A howling coyote provided some respite. To us, it seemed this same coyote accompanied us at a distance, the same for days, and while we lacked in an hourglass, the unreliable sundials of our shadows in the sand suggested that he howled in intervals that drew closer together, heralding each new push forward. Not unlike contractions. Speaking of which, they say that the sun should never rise and set on a laboring woman, but this sun had stopped rising and setting and just seemed to suspend between the teeth of our unseen coyote companion, who released it only to howl. I hallucinated water, of course. I hallucinated the water from the stones, melted from the sand, and then, with a previously unknown reservoir of imagination, one extreme suffering meets old serenity, I conjured forth the juice of the sun like an